the work I do for the public, the animals we save, the hundreds of animals, yeah, forever homes. That's the most memorable thing. Oh, it's all over the way. It's tweet. It would have to be better health for my wife. A flamingo on steroids.
Great Dane.
Why?
That's what Goofy is. Ensure that the team is taken care of, definitely. Don would probably be a wolf. He's a leader of the pack, definitely.
I would say dedicated. Walking into dispatch, and when we hand him a pile of calls, saying, thank you very much. Don't even be cooking the worm, he ain't got no time. Just eat it raw and run out the door.
Probably doing the annual dinners for many, many years. I think I'd like it to be a border collie.
Why?
Because I've always thought that they were beautiful dogs, and if properly trained and loved, they are very good with children. And I've always just liked their colors and just liked them overall. I think faith is very important. Your family and being able to enjoy your work. This is a good one.
You're gonna make me do this? Caw!
My, probably some kind of a lap dog. She's very loving and very compassionate. Completely cover it in some kind of other flavor and cook it till you didn't know it was a worm anymore. I think she'd be a mama bear, taking care of her cubs, her granddaughters.
She's a chatterbox. She loves talking and sharing her stories about her family and about life. Kind. I would say a dove, just because they're pure and beautiful and they symbolize so many great things. And I think that Francine brings a lot to this world, and she's very kind and loving.
Being happy, healthy, good friends. More education. And enjoy life a little more. I have to be a chihuahua.
Why is that?
I got attitude. But every animal here had a forever home. Like I know what I'm doing. Probably, there's been a couple, but like my fosters. Seeing them come from a tragic story to a perfect ending and finding a good home. And just seeing what I can do to help them.
I don't know what animal, but whatever animal, it would have to be an animal that was like very giving and caring, because she's always there to help anybody. So I don't know what animal that would be, but that's Candy. She's always going to help somebody. Barbecue. Coffee.
Chihuahua. I think she would be a lion because she is a go-getter. She drinks coffee.
Always have animals. Always have animals in your life. Because no matter what happens in life, no matter all the hurts and pains, for some reason the animal tends to just pick you up and make you want to keep going forward. English Bulldog. And if it wasn't an English Bulldog, I would be an Australian Shepherd. Love those breeds. Ah, wow. Klondike bar. I'd do about 200 push-ups. Even though I probably couldn't do them now. I'd do just about anything for a Klondike bar. I'm sexy and you know it. That's what it would be. Sexy and I know it.
Only one?
Witty. He talks a lot. Probably barbecue it.
Oh my gosh. A dork. He likes to do his Michael Jackson dance moves. Anytime anything gets stressed out, he pulls it off.
Is he good?
Yeah, kind of. I think he would be a bear. He's more, everybody thinks that he's like mean and scary, but he really isn't. He's like a lovely teddy bear type of animal.
It's a great organization to work for. The secret to a good life is to follow what it is that you find enjoyable in life. It would be the winning lottery numbers to that $1 billion lottery jackpot. A nice vacation island all to myself. A lot of interesting experiences working in animal control side of things with anything from crazy people to crazy animals that we deal with. So that's been really, really fun to deal with. They're all great experiences, so I can't really say just one best one.
Irish Wolfhound. I wouldn't. Good.
A chihuahua. Entertaining. I think he would be an Irish wolfhound dog because that's his favorite breed and it's a bigger, kind of intimidating and not very aggressive, but not very nice either. Can be a little aggressive, can be nice. Loving on the animals too much. An itty bitty pity.
She would. She would be like, oh no, it's living, I can't. But maybe bake it.
If she were any animal, well, it would be the same as a chihuahua because she has a big bark, but like a little bite. Intense. The stove.
I think it was my first day. It was my most memorable moment. That's what I remember. I remember being greeted by individuals who worked here, and they were so excited. They went like, oh, you're Linda Van Kirk. And I was kind of like, well, yeah, I am. Oh, we're so happy to see you. And I kept thinking, I wonder why. Well, now I know. I'm going to say Labrador Retriever because I love labs and they're always so friendly, they're outgoing, their tails are always wagging, and they love to play, they enjoy life. And I think that's what I would want to be as a lab. Oh my God. I like ducks. I've been trying to steal my neighbor's ducks. Oh my God, this is okay. All right, we're gonna cut this one right here. So quack, 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 quack. And I've been trying to speak duck language to capture my neighbor's ducks.
Oh, I think she'd be a Shih Tzu. Fabulous. A deer.
And why?
Because she's gentle and kind and caring.
I would say ducking and dodging, but she doesn't do that. She has a habit of hiring awesome people. She gets out of their way and she lets them blow up. I gotta say that is the best habit of hers that she's got going on. Boss. Oh my, Linda Van Kirk, boss lady, you know, definitely like that.
Thank you, Candy, for your service.
Thank you, Dee, for your service. You're amazing to work with. Thanks.
Thank you, Francine, for your service. I appreciate you.
Thank you, boss lady, Linda. Thank you for your service.
Thank you, Don, for your service.
Thank you, Candy, for your service.
Thank you, Linda, for your service. Norm had big shoes to fill, and he did it in such a graceful way. We thank you very much, and we love you.
Thank you, Noah, for your service.
Thank you, Dee, we love you.
Thank you, Francine, for your service. You're an amazing woman.
Thanks, Noah. You're the best.